As his pastime, that supreme personality of Godhead, the greatest of the great, accepted the subtle material energy, which is invested with the three material modes of nature, and which is related with Vishnu.
Sāyaśa prakṛtiṁ sukṣmāṁ daivīṁ gunavāṁ vibhu yadikṣayā upakatāṁ abhapadyata līlaya. So, Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, as he says, that sambhavami atmamaya, sambhavami atmamaya, Krishna and the living entities, both of them are the same quality, but when the living entities come in this material world, he is forced by the prakriti, by the material nature. But when Krishna comes, he is not forced, but by his free will, yadichaya, upagatam. Yadichaya upagatam, abhapadyata lila. Sometimes the Mayavadi philosophers, they also take the living entities within this material world as lila. That is not lila. Lila refers to the pastimes of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Nobody says that the living entity has come in this material for lila. At least the Vaishnava philosophers do not agree that. It is contradictory. Krishna says that when I come, jada jada hi dharma sablani bhavati bharata, bhuthanam adharmas, we should not accept Krishna's coming within this material world and our coming in this material in the same process. Krishna comes as he is. He does not change. And because he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Almighty, even if he comes within this material world, the material qualities do not affect him. That is, ishanam. Just like a physician, a doctor, medical man, he goes to the hospital to treat the infected patients. So, he is not affected by the infection. He has got such precautionary measures, are he so equipped with that he is not infected with the disease. Those who are weak, that is stated in the Bhagavatam, etat isanam ishasya, that is isha, isha means the controller. Rather, if something infects us, come in touch with the Supreme Personality of Godhead, it becomes purified. Tejasam nadosha, it is said. Another example can be given, just like the sunshine absorbs water in from urine or any infectious place, any filthy place, the sun absorbs the water. But the sun is not infected, because it is very powerful. Similarly, if you try to absorb water from the urine, then you will be infected. That is called etat isasya isanam. Even those who are devotees, they are not infected by the three modes of material nature. We have many times repeated this verse of Bhagavad Gita, Manchabhya vicharini bhakti yogi naja sevate sagunan samatitta etan brahma bhuyaya kalpate. So, even the ordinary living entities, those who are devotees, they are not infected by the three modes of material nature. How we can expect the Supreme Lord can be infected by the three modes of material nature? That is not possible. This is not, even from ordinary argument, it cannot be accepted. Krishna or Krishna's incarnation, there are hundreds and thousands of incarnation. Ramadi murtishu kalaniyame natishthan nana avataram akarat bhuvaneshu kintu. Krishna sang samabhava paramappumanaju govindamadi purusham tamam bhajam. Krishna has innumerable expansions. Ramadi, Ram, Lord Ramchandra is also Krishna's expansion. Ramadi murtishu kala. Kala means expansion of the expansion. Just like, oh, I have given this example many times, this original candle, and you ignite another candle, that is second candle, and from the second, from the third, from the third, the fourth, in this way, all the candles, although you say this is first candle, second candle, third candle, fourth candle, but they are all equally powerful. So far candle power is concerned, they are equally the same. Similarly, Krishna's incarnation, Krishna is the origin, Krishna's the Bhagavan Sam, the origin person, Adi Purusha, Govindam Adi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami. Still, the expansion of Krishna, that's like the first expansion is Balaram, then Sankarsan, Pradyumna, Niruddha, then Narayan, and again Sankarsan, Pradyumna, Niruddha, then Mahavishnu, then from Mahavishnu, Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, from Garbhodakshaya Vishnu to Kiradakshaya Vishnu, from Kiradakshaya Vishnu, there are innumerable expansions, Paramatma expansion, Ishara Sarvahutanam Vidyeshwarjunatishtati. So in this way, there is, this Srimad Bhagavati says, expansion of Krishna are so many, just like incessant waves in the river or in the ocean. So that is one status of expansion. And another expansion is the jiva-tattva. We are also expansion. In the Varaha Puran, it is said, samsa and vibhinnaamsa. The vibhinnaamsa expansion, they are also innumerable jivas. We are also expansion of Krishna. But samsa and vibhinnaamsa. So the vibhinnaamsa expansion, they are minute. And the samsa expansion, they are vibhu, unlimited. So in this way, we have to understand the distinction between samsa and vibhinnaamsa. When samsa expansion comes within this material world, he remains vibhu or prabhu. And the vibhinnaamsa expansion is always anu, very small, or servant. One is prabhu and the other is servant. One is vibhu and the other is anu. So the anu, vibhinnaamsa jiva, when he comes within this material world. He becomes entrapped, or he is that jyoti. In the previous verse we have studied jyoti, vibhinnaṃsa, living entity. We are also jyoti, just like spark. The original fire is also fire, and the spark, fire, that is also fire. Quality the same, but a spark, when it falls down on your cloth, it can burn a little portion. Similarly, if the whole fire comes, then you become burned into pieces. The same example again, the sun and the sun sign. Sun sign is combination, a small particle of shining molecules. Similarly, we are also the same spark. Dipa-chari-vahi-dasam-taram-abhupetya-dipayate. Krishna and his expansion, they are all the same. And we, vibhinnaṃsa jīva, we are very small. Therefore, our condition is different from Krishna. Krishna is not infected by the material qualities, but we become infected. Namāṁ karmāni nimpanti, namī karma phales priha, it is said in the Bhagavad Gita. The activities in this material world, Krishna remains unaffected. But we, being a small particle, we become infected by the qualities. Tirbhi gunoi bhavi. So those who are too much infected by these material qualities, they cannot understand Krishna. Naham prakasa sarvasya yogamaya samavrita. They think that Krishna and we are the same, but that is not the fact. Abhijananti manamurha manasim tunumasita. Because Krishna comes as human being, we may think that Krishna is as good as I am. No, that should not be. Krishna is vibho and we are onu. Krishna is master and we are servant. That is our eternal relationship. We should not forget that. And saiva prakritim sukshang devim gunamayim vibhu. Prakriti, prakriti, this prakriti is also Krishna's. Krishna, the supreme powerful, he can utilize the prakriti as he likes. He is not controlled by prakriti. But we are controlled by prakriti. Because he is vibhu. Vibhu means the great. So you cannot say great, maya or prakriti is greater than Krishna. You cannot say. Then God is not great. If something is greater than God, then you cannot say God is great. If you accept this, that there is no more greater identity than Krishna, then you can say Krishna is great, or Krishna cannot be entrapped. Nūnaṁ mahatāṁ tatra. If you are smaller, then you can be overpowered by the great. If you are gone, if your strength is lesser than another man, say two wrestlers, if one wrestler is more powerful, he can defeat the other wrestler. So therefore, here it is said, vibhu, Krishna is vibhu, and if he is covered by maya, just the mayavadi philosopher thinks that when God comes within this material world, he is also covered by maya. He is not covered by maya. If maya is greater than Krishna, then maya can cover Krishna. But that is not the fact. Krishna says, mama maya. That means, māmi vaja prapadnante māyā mētāṁ taraṁ tete. If one surrenders to Krishna, then he becomes free from the clutches of Maya. The how Krishna can be caught by Maya? This is contradictory. If anyone surrenders to Krishna, he becomes free from the influence of Maya, simply by surrendering. Then how Krishna can be influenced by Maya? It is common sense. By surrendering to Krishna, by becoming a devotee of Krishna, you become free from the clutches of Maya. Māmi uja parvadhante, simply by surrendering. Maya mitāṁ sarantit. So never think that Krishna, the Mayavadi thinks like that, that we are one, Krishna and we are one. Yes, we are one in quality, the same thing, just like the fire and the spark, one in burning capacity. Even a small spark of the fire, it can burn. So we are one in the spiritual quality, but in quantity, we are different. Same example, Vibhu and all. This is very nice verse in the Bhagavad Gita. Māmi vaja prapadnanti māyāmi tāṁ sarantī. Then another verse is there. Apasat purusam purnam māyāñca tat apāśrayam bhakti yogena manasi sammak pranihate amale. Vasudev, when he was instructed by his spiritual master Narad Muni to write Srimad Bhagavatam, at that time by bhakti yoga meditation he could see the Supreme Personality of Godhead and this Maya also. But it is said, Maya chidat apasrayam. Maya is situated in the backside, without any influence upon Krishna, apasrayam, under the control. So Maya is always controlled. Krishna is the controller of Maya. In another place, in the Brahma Sanghita, it is said, Sisti sthiti palaya sadhana shakti reka chai vajasya bhavanani vibharti durga. Durga is the material energy. And she has got immense power. Sisti sthiti palaya sadhana shakti. She is controlling this creation of this whole universe, Sisti. And sthiti is maintenance. And pralaya, three things she is controlling. She is so powerful. Sisti sthiti palaya sadhana shakti rita chai vajasya bhuvanani vibharti durga. She Durga shakti, material energy, she is so powerful, but it is working chai va, just like shadow. Shadow has no independent capacity. It is dependent on the substance and shadow. So Krishna is the substance, and the power derived from Krishna partially exhibited by the Durga Shakti. In the Upanishad also it is said, natasya karyam karananca vidyate natasya samam adhikascha drishyate. Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God, he has nothing to do. Natasya karjam karanancha vidyate. Natasya sama. Nobody is equal to him. Krishna also says in the Bhagavad Gita, matta paratara nanya kaschi. There is nothing superior than me. The Supreme. And in Srimad Bhagavatam also it is said, Om namo bhagavate vasudevaya sattam param dhimahi. That is the supreme truth. So all the shastras will say that Krishna or the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he has got different expansions, unlimited. Although Krishna is one, but he can expand himself into many, many millions. Advaita achyute anadi anantarupam. Anantarupam. And each rupam is acting in some universe. Just like at this time, here you find darkness in Bombay, but the sun is present in all his different phases all over the world. Sun rises in the morning at, say, 7 o'clock. So this 7 o'clock to next 7 o'clock, in evening 7 o'clock, you'll find, if you immediately take information, somewhere it is 7 o'clock, somewhere it is 12 o'clock, somewhere it is 6 o'clock, somewhere it is... All the time formula of the sun is present, although we are seeing there is no sun. Similarly, Krishna is present throughout the whole universe in some feature. In one universe you'll find Krishna is taking birth, Janmashtami. And some universe will see Krishna is playing with the coward boy, somewhere in this way. Therefore it is called Nitya Lila. Nitya Lila means the Janmashtami Lila is going on permanently, somewhere or other. Therefore it is called Lilaya, Jadikchaya. So this is a great science, Krishna science, Krishna Tattva. So we have to learn from the authorized Vedic literature about Krishna, and that is required in human life, because if we simply understand the truth about Krishna, janma karma chaiva divyam, which is divine, transcendental, jo janati tattvata, if you try to understand and if you become fortunate to understand the divine nature of Krishna's lila, then you become liberated immediately. Taktadi hanga punarjanmano iti mam iti kamsa. The Sankha philosophy of Kapildev is explained in this way to understand Krishna. So Krishna jadichaya upagatam abhapadvata lila. Krishna is lila, and our coming here is not lila. We are forced. We are forced. Karmana daiva netrena deha upapati. And Krishna's body is Satchidananda vigraha. Krishna's body is not material. Even if we think it is material, still it is Satchidananda vigraha. Just like one can argue that here is Krishna's form, it is made of stone. How it is Satchidananda vigraha? But if you know the nature of Krishna, even he appears as stone, is still he Satchidananda vigraha. How? Because the stone is also energy of Krishna. That is said in the Upanishad, natasya karyam karanam cha vidyate natasya sama adhikaschati parasya shakti vividhaiva sriyate. So this stone is also another energy of Krishna. Another energy of Krishna, and Krishna is all-powerful. He can utilize his energy in any way. He can utilize his energy in any way, just like an electrician. He knows how to utilize the electricity for the refrigerator and the heater. Although the heating process is just opposite of the cooling process, and we see opposite. Similarly, material nature and spiritual nature are just opposite. But the same way, the electricity utilized for heating and electricity utilized for cooling, the and energy is the same, but it is the manipulation of the engineer which can turn heat into cold and cold into heat. So therefore, for Krishna there is no material nature. Everything is spiritual nature. Even Krishna appears as material form, as stone, as matter. Still, one who knows Krishna, he can derive Krishna's favor from any form. Otherwise, the devotees are recommended to worship the deity in the temple. So, do you think that the acharyas and the shastra have advised them to waste their time by worshipping a stone? It is all recommended by the acharyas. Big acharyas, just like Ramanuja acharya. He established hundreds of temples all over India. Lakshmi Narayan temple, especially the Ramanuja Sampradaya. Similarly, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Sampradaya established hundreds of temples, Radha Krishna, big acharya. Do you mean to say they did mistake as some people of our India, they say there is no need of worshipping in the temple. No. Why not need? Acharya upasanam, that is recommended. Yeah. Acharyas, they have established temples. Many hundreds of thousands of temples of Vishnu Mandir. So this should be worshipped. Otherwise, you cannot. Mahajana jena gatasya pantha. If you do not follow acharyas, then tadviddhi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya upadakshanti tadgyanam jnanina tattadarshina. Tattva the acharyas are tattadarshi. They know how to make you devotee. Therefore they are prescribed. And Krishna in his any condition life, he is Sachidananda Vigraha. Ishara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha. Anadi Radhi Govinda Sarvakarana Karanam. You try to understand Krishna. You try to understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Try to understand your relationship and act accordingly. Then your life will be successful.